It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 25 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, I'm one of your hosts, and with me, as always, is Finn Steele.
Hello.
How you doing?
Very good, thank you. I'm doing glorious. Thanks for asking.
One take.
Yeah, one take wonder.
Yeah. I'm not doing too good today.
No, not feeling good.
No, I'm under the weather.
Oh dear.
Yeah, I've got some like cold shit that's just doing me in.
No, that's not good. Stay away from me.
And
don't breathe on me.
You get ill really quick.
Yeah. Me?
Yeah, you are always ill.
I am. Well, I was back then when you first started.
Back then. Like it was.
All those years ago. You know, eons ago.
Ye oldie times.
I know, but I mean, when you first started, I was just coming off like a bad flu. I was kind of keeping like, I don't know, more and more bad stuff. But
you've had a good streak, actually.
Yeah. I'm doing good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
It's my turn now.
Yeah, it's your turn. Your turn to suffer.
I got a bad neck as well. I was going to like put some frozen peas on it.
Oh.
But like I took some painkillers, so it sort of numbed it for a little while. They've done their job, which is, you know, more than I can say than what they usually do.
Yeah, painkillers a bit hit miss.
So probably if you hear me sort of like screaming pain sort of halfway through this, it's because they've worn off.
Yeah. Or if you just stop talking, it means you passed out because it's taking too many.
Yeah, pretty much. So I'm a little bit under the weather.
That's not good.
What have you been doing since we last spoke? Have you been doing anything? You've been editing our videos?
Editing videos, yes, always. Editing podcasts, of course. Playing a lot of Overwatch, because, you know me.
Yeah.
Yeah, not really much else. Played some more Tokyo Mirage Sessions, your favourite game on the Wii U.
Oh, yeah, I loved it. Yeah. Great.
But other than that, yeah, same old. How about you?
Well, I went to see Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah? How was it?
It was great.
Yeah? You liked it?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it, yeah.
Oh, good.
I don't understand what critics' problem is.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of the people that I've spoken to who have seen it, like, have said they really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I think like, it's just, I don't know, from like an artistic, quote-unquote, standpoint, it just wasn't that good, I guess. I don't know. I didn't get it.
Have you seen it?
Nope. But I'm sure it'd be good, and I like that kind of stuff.
Oh.
I like Batman vs. Superman, so I sort of like that.
Oh, you've seen Batman vs. Superman?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. Critics pan that as well.
Yeah.
I think it's mainly because they don't know who these characters are.
Yeah,
like
maybe.
Batman and Superman, fine. People know who they are.
Yeah.
Like, with Suicide Squad, like, I don't imagine that many critics are sitting there reading the source material.
Yeah, probably not. Like, into all the comics and things. Ah, that's why this happened. Huh?
Yeah. I think that's what it is. Well, I personally loved it, and I think you'll probably love it as well.
Yeah, but
yeah, it was great.
Awesome.
Then I went to, me and friend of the show, Steve, we went to sunny London town on Sunday to watch our rival teams compete against each other.
Ooh, nice.
In the soccer.
Epic rivalry.
Which was good. People in London, or people in general, I think, maybe just can't get their heads around rival fans being friends.
Yeah.
We were walking around. I was wearing a red Man United shirt, and he was wearing a blue Leicester shirt.
Of course.
And like, we just get getting funny looks all day, and like a couple of comments from people, and people just, I think it just confused people.
Yeah.
Like, they thought we were completely mental walking around together, like being friends and rival fans. Like, they should surely be fighting each other.
Yes, fighting in the streets.
They should be engaging in a round of fisticuffs, I feel. Instead of walking around smiling and having photos taken and things like this.
Yeah, I don't know. Football fans are weird.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, no, I mean, all football excluded, fans, of course. Just, you know,
it can be a strange thing, I think, to be around. But yeah, it was good fun. We had a good day. We had a really good day.
Yeah, good. Fun day out.
Yeah, it was a fun day.
Did you like my message to you about the football?
Yeah, I did. It was like it was a trainer, golf.
Mm-hmm.
And was there a football in there as well?
It was a basketball.
Oh, it was a basketball. Yeah. Right.
It's just imagine like you bounce the ball with your hands and you kick it as far as you can to get it in the hole, get a hole in one. That's how football works, isn't it?
Yes, that is exactly how football works.
Got it. See, aren't they sports?
I think that's most sports.
Yeah. David Beckham, he's a sports.
Yeah. He plays that base football that you've just mentioned there.
Yeah, the basket golf ball.
Foot kickball.
Yes, foot kickball. There you go.
Yeah. That's a new sport.
New sport. Sonny Finn invented. All legends are Sonny Finn. Copyright. Yeah. You're seal.
2016.
Yeah.
That's ours.
It's ours now.
Foot kickball.
Yeah. Need to get someone to make the game of it.
So when foot kickball appears on the PS Store next year for $7.99. In fact, we'll let them have it on PlayStation Plus, like Rocket League.
Yeah, sure, why not?
And we'll build success like that.
Yeah, there you go.
I think this could work.
I think
this is a flawless idea.
Yeah.
So Foot Kickball coming to a PS4 and an Xbox One near you.
Absolutely. Coming soon.
Yeah, maybe on Steam as well.
Yeah, why not?
Maybe not? Did you say why not?
Well, yeah, why not?
Oh, okay, why not? Yeah, sure.
Xbox One, all in.
Yeah. We are the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a weekly wrestling and video game podcast.
We are.
That posts every single Friday on iTunes, SoundCloud, and all other podcast services.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk video games.
Yes.
So you mentioned that you've been playing Overwatch.
I have.
Have you been playing anything else?
Not a huge amount. Just, you know, old bits and bobs.
Bits and bobs.
Stuff, yeah.
It's a good game.
Yeah, it's my favourite game, Bits and Bobs.
Yeah, I like that game. I played through it once, so I thought it was fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
we like the bits of the bobs in it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's the bit where you, obviously, you control a character called Bob.
Yeah.
And you have to find bits.
Find all the bits,
who's your friend.
Yeah, exactly. And he,
yeah.
You know, it's Bits and Bobs. Like Ratchet and Clank. But
it's exactly like Ratchet and Clank.
Exactly.
But the characters are called Bits and Bobs.
Exactly.
I feel like...
Copyright 2016, Sonny Finn.
Yeah.
And PS4.
Yeah, well, this is coming out on PlayStation Plus and be on Xbox One Games with Gold next year at some point.
Yes.
Soon after Foot Kickball.
Which is renting games at hire us at EA or something.
I know. This is like, that's two games we've created in like 2 minutes.
Exactly, yeah, it's great. We're geniuses.
It's like a game a minute.
Yeah, it's great. we're the best game designers.
Yeah, well, that's clear from just the first, what are we, 6 minutes into this podcast. It's clear that we are very smart.
Yes, we're expert game people.
Yes.
Yes.
I had an idea for a game, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Basically, it's like a superhero game. So I'd like ripped off Infamous.
Okay.
Sort of. I'd ripped off Infamous and Kick-Ass and then added my own little twist.
Right.
Okay, so it doesn't involve superpowers, really, either. Just like a cut-rate Batman.
Right, like Grand Theft Auto?
Yeah, sort of, yeah. But. So, like, it's going to be open world,
okay.
Set in a town that I've not really figured out yet. So it's going well so far.
Ninkly.
Yeah. So, basically, you see all this crime going on, and the main character is not happy about it. So he goes, takes it upon himself to, don some sort of costume and go out and try and stop crime.
Right.
The press catch on to this, and then... You know, the guy starts picking up sponsors. And this is going to be part of the game. You pick up sponsors for doing these heroic acts.
Okay.
Okay. And the more money you get from the sponsors, the more good gear you can buy to be a better superhero.
Nice.
It's going to be like an action comedy superhero game.
I see.
How do you feel about this?
Yeah, sounds good. Sounds like Kick-Ass, but...
Hey, it's got sponsors in there. There's no sponsors.
But sponsors, yeah. But with like grid. Grid 1 on there.
Yeah, DC. Sure.
Yeah,
it's got it could be like that, but it's going to be like open world. And it's going to be funny.
Cool.
So yeah, we'll make that as well.
Yeah, we'll make that.
That's going to be a AAA title. That's not going to be Football or the other one, Bits and Bobs. It's going to be like a AAA game. So it'll be our studio's first AAA game.
Okay, sounds good to me.
Yeah.
I'm down.
Okay. We'll find somebody to make these games.
Yes.
And we'll never do this podcast ever again because we'll be so rich off these games.
Yeah. We'll send them to Microsoft for like $5 billion.
Yeah,
like
they can be Xbox years. One and PC exclusives. We're not bothered. We'll sell out. We're really not bothered.
We'll be the next notch from Minecraft.
Sure.
Yeah.
And then what's going to happen is we're going to make a wrestling game.
Yes.
The one that we want to make.
Yes.
Like a really good wrestling game.
Reinventing the Aki engine.
Yes. We're going to rip it off is what's going to happen.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
It's going to be glorious.
Or with all this money that we've made from Bits and Bobs, Foot Kickball, and our as of yet untitled superhero action comedy game.
TBA.
Yes. We'll buy the Aki engine and we'll
that's
just good. Make it an amazing wrestling game.
It's great idea.
And we'll be in it as well.
Yeah, great. Well, that's all we just sorted then.
We've literally we've not predicted it, we've made our future.
Yeah, it's happening.
Okay.
This is our lives now. So support us while you can.
Yeah, so enjoy the podcast while it's still a real thing.
Yeah.
Because when we're rich as fuck, right, and we're both sitting with grills in our like gold grills in our mouths and like chains and ice on our necks, not like ice that I'm gonna have after the podcast on my neck. Not frozen peas,
not frozen
I'm
peas
talking
on your
like
necks.
A Jesus piece.
Nice.
What is this?
I don't know. what's happened to our podcast?
I don't know. I've not really been playing much this week.
No.
Just going straight back into
stuff. Yeah.
I say not much. I've not been playing like a wide variety. I've been hammering Pro Evolution Soccer 2016.
Oh yeah.
Like my Master League has just got me. Like cool. Right now. Like, the new one's out in 5 weeks and I'm still, like, playing this one.
Well, that's good. It means it's got a lot of longevity.
Yeah.
Longevity.
Longevity.
Yeah.
Yeah. I started Shadow Complex Remastered, finally.
Nice. It's a good game.
Great game. There's a funny part at the beginning of the game. You know, like, that first bit where that dude is, like, in the suit?
Oh, yeah.
And you shoot that helicopter down? There's a bit just before that in, like, the cutscene where there's, like, guys in suits and then soldiers, like, shooting. But they're not behind cover or anything. They're just shooting at each other and missing. Like, this is the shittest soldiers and the worst undercover guys in suits of all time.
Like
shooting at each other.
Yeah.
Like, from me to you away right now.
Awesome.
But yeah, I've not really been playing much else. I've been doing a bit of achievement whoring, really.
Yeah.
I've dipped and dabbed, but I'm going to dip into...
That's another Finn and Sonny Finn classic.
What's that?
Dip and Dab. It's like sequel to Bits and Bobs.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
That's actually... They're the bad guys in Bits and Bob.
Bob, I get it.
Yeah.
That's a good plan. And then in the sequel, you'll be playing as bad guys.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like a spin-off.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Sounds good. The people will want it.
Absolutely. Sorry. Distracted.
No, don't be sorry. Don't be sorry. It's like the people are hearing the future... Like, unfold right before their ears.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're welcome, Internet.
You are very welcome. Buy our games.
Yes.
When they come out next year.
Yeah.
And if you want to buy, like, a copy for $1,300, like the guy who bought No Man's Sky.
Yeah, yeah. Just send us the money to our PayPal account.
Buy it off eBay. Just buy it from us. We'll sell it you for that money.
Yeah, got the thing. It's easy to limit.
That's fine. Right, we've got some gaming news.
Yes.
Not much. Just, like... Bits and bobs.
Yeah.
We're going to keep dropping these in there. XCOM has been delayed. XCOM 2 has been delayed by 3 weeks on console.
No.
Just coming out September the 22nd or the 27th.
That's
as opposed to September the 2nd. That's fine.
Unless it's not in October when every other game in the world comes out.
Yeah, I know. Although September's going to be busy and expensive.
Well, that's true, yeah.
I'm looking forward to that a lot.
Yeah, me too.
Great. You going to get it?
Yep.
That's going to get it on PS4 or Xbox One?
PS4, probably.
Okay.
Get most things at PS4 if I can.
What's that?
Just gotta get most things at PS4, just because, I don't know, I like it better.
But your gamer score is so high.
It
on
is.
Xbox One.
But I feel like I've reached my limit, and I need to get my trophies up to that level.
Right.
And so I've, like, two big scores on both consoles.
How do you feel like you're doing on that?
Okay.
I think it's a harder slot on PlayStation to get trophies.
Yeah, I've got to, like, because with Xbox, I kind of started at the beginning with everyone else. With PS, PlayStation stuff, I'm, like, lagging behind. I have to catch up a bit.
Yeah.
But it's not okay. I've got 40 platinums now, I think. It's okay.
You are the bomb.
I am.
You are.
I'm the bomb diggity.
Speaking of bomb, the Battleborn bombed, as predicted. I think we said this like on one of the very early episodes of our podcast.
Yeah.
Like
it's just a bad time to release your game.
It was so poor from Gearbox.
Yeah.
I mean, they must have known, like, putting it up against the very hyped Overwatch. That it was going to fail and fail probably quite badly.
Yeah.
And unfortunately it has. I mean, they still have hopes for it, apparently.
Published
by 2K, made by Gearbox. That sounds right, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Apparently they still have high hopes for it.
Oh. But I think it's if they're like waiting until about now, when people have been playing Overwatch, might be getting a bit tired of Overwatch, want something a bit different, then probably would have been way better. And they would have had more time to work on it as well. So,
you know what I think is going to happen?
What's that?
Free to play.
That's a good... Yes, yeah.
Like Evolve. Evolve has just gone free to play on PC.
It has, yep.
And I assume that's going to happen on console as well.
I would have thought so.
I really liked Evolve. It got a lot of crap, but I like it.
I like the idea of it.
Really good idea. Mm. I prefer being the person than the monster, but I like the idea of both.
Oh, cool.
But when it becomes free to play, I'll certainly download it.
Oh, yeah, me too.
But I'm not... I'm disappointed. I don't want to see any game do badly.
Yeah.
But, and it's inevitable that some have to, unfortunately. But it's just a stupid time to bring it out.
Yeah. It wasn't a bad game. It's just, compared to Overwatch, it was never going to...
It's not a bad game. It's not a good game.
It's the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or not in this case.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rocket League has a new mode coming.
Sweet.
Called Rumble.
All right.
It's a free update. It's coming in September.
Mm-hmm.
It looks cool. It's like adds power-ups to the cars and there's some random stuff happening in the Rocket League arena.
Oh, yeah.
Which looks very cool. There's a cool trailer out for it. You should have a look for it. But it comes in September.
Sweet. Love me some Rocket League.
adding great content to an already great game.
Yeah, definitely.
I haven't played it in a while, but I really suck at it. You don't suck at it because like with me, you and Lit were playing.
Oh yeah.
And you two are like really good, and there's me, I'm just like driving around.
Yeah, I'm driving circle.
Yeah, that's literally it. I'm like, yeah, I'm driving after the ball. I'm like a dog, like chasing its own tail. Yeah. That's basically what I am on Rocket League.
That's all right. I played quite recently with Lit, actually, playing some basketball mode.
Oh, how is it? I haven't even tried it.
It's really fun, actually. Really hard to like aim it up and into the basket, but we've got the hang of it. I think we won most of the games we played, so
right, that's good.
Okay. Not that I'm trying to brag.
Has it added any new trophies to it?
There are for like the cars, different cards and stuff you can buy. We have to pay money for them, sadly.
Oh, but, well, you get trophies for that, though?
Yeah, the trophies. Okay.
Cause I noticed there's a Batman versus Superman car on it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool. I think it's just the Batmobile, actually, from the
film. Oh, yeah, I think so, actually. I'm not sure that
Superman doesn't need a car. So.
No, yeah, that's true. But, yeah.
He's literally faster than any car.
It's true.
Yeah.
Faster than a speeding bullet, I believe.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I believe that to be the old sort of...
That's a
description of Superman.
Yeah, that's the last time I looked at any Superman stuff. It's definitely a new film.
Well, like in the late 30s.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
I'm actually 100 years old.
Which version of Batman vs Superman did you watch? Did you watch the normal version or the 3-hour version?
The shorter version.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
The 3-hour version clears it all up. It makes a bit more sense.
All right, okay.
So, when you've got a spare 3 hours, watch it.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah,
it should be never.
Right, okay. Are you too busy editing our videos and
exactly,
podcast?
Yeah. That and everything else.
Sure. Finn's favourite game, Overwatch.
Yay.
Has hit 15 million plus players. They have announced on social media.
That's a big number.
It's a very big number.
Good job.
The gift that they used was, it looked like Rocket League, but I'm assuming that's what that Olympic game is.
Probably Lucio Ball, yeah.
Right.
But,
That's a lot of players, and it's been super successful.
Super successful. It's a really good game. It's rare for me to get into like a shooter like this, but it's cool because it's like you don't have to be good at shooters to like play it.
I agree.
Like characters who don't have guns, for example, like Reinhardt has a big hammer. It's Mercy with like a healing beam. But yeah, it's awesome. I love it. The only thing I don't love about it is the loot box system they've got. I don't know, it's a bit. It encourages like...
It's only cosmetic stuff though.
Yeah, it is. But it encourages like, if you want a specific skin, you have to buy like 50 loot boxes for a ridiculous amount of money and just hope you get the right one you want.
Real money or?
Yeah. You can't just
but
like...
You can unlock them in the game though, can't you?
You can, but you have to, you unlock one box every level, which takes quite a while. It's like 5 games to level up. It's like, it takes a long time.
Oh God.
Yeah, it's a pain. But,
I can see the pain on your face.
Yeah, I really want that. Some skins that I really like, but I'm never going to get because
right.
My luck's crap with loot boxes. Right. And I'm not going to pay like a crazy amount of money for them. So.
I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, but still, it's a fun game and I love it.
To be honest, you look like you're genuinely hurting.
It hurts inside, man.
Yeah. I need those skins.
I need them, man. I need the skins.
I just, my luck is so bad. Transformers Fall of Cybertron.
Mm-hmm.
Has surprisingly released on Xbox One and PlayStation 4 this week.
Nice. Is it the good ones?
Really good ones.
Mm.
But they're highly priced. It's the same sort of deal with Marvel Ultimate Alliance 1 and 2, so they're expensive.
Yeah.
But they are really good games. Right, I think it's just one of them, Fall of Cybertron. There's two.
One.
I think the other one's Rise of Cybertron, I don't even know.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Or War of Cybertron.
Same thing on Cybertron.
Cybertron, yes. Yeah. but they're really good games. It looks like I don't know what Activision are doing here.
Yeah, they're like getting out all the stuff.
It's like, right, here's a load of games that we made that you may have missed. Here they are for an extortionate price and slightly remastered.
Yeah.
And when I say slightly remastered, they've put a little bit of gloss on the gameplay because Ultimate Alliance has not had the cutscenes touched.
Has not, oh dear.
They are bad.
Ooh.
Which is weird because... I was playing Ultimate Alliance 2 on PS4, and the cutscenes are really bad on that.
Oh, yeah.
But then I was playing Ultimate Alliance 1 on Xbox One, and the cutscenes are better on that.
Huh. Weird. Were they doing, like, in-engine, the cutscenes on that one? Or was it, like,
CGI? No. They were, like, CGI. Oh, right. Like, you know, like a CG cutscene.
Weird.
Very weird. But either way, I mean, that's a really good game. I'm going to wait for it to come down in price.
How much is it in minutes? Like...
£40.
Ew,
I'm not paying that for it.
No way.
But, I mean, they are really good games. Really, really good games.
Yeah.
But no, I'm not paying that.
Yeah, me neither. That's a bit much, Activision. What are you doing?
But at Christmas, when it's £15, go ahead and buy it because it's fantastic.
Yes.
Speaking of remasters, Dead Rising, that was rumoured.
Oh, yeah.
The collection is indeed coming out. It has been confirmed.
Yay.
September the 13th.
Sweet.
All three will cost you $50 if you pre-order it now, which is, what, £35-ish? I don't know what the exchange rate is at the minute.
Something like that, yeah.
Either way.
Sounds about right.
I'm not into them games, so I'm not going to touch them, but if you like Dead Rising and want to play all three, then they are coming.
Yeah, well, I really like Dead Rising.
We knew they were coming.
Yeah. But I love that kind of stuff. So yeah, I don't know if I'll buy them again. Depending, I don't know. Maybe when it comes down to price, I will.
I think, again, it's one of these things that when it comes down in price, it's well worth a look.
Yeah. There's just so many games. I've said this loads of times, but so many games I've got on my backlog that I haven't even touched.
Christmas sales on PSN are ridiculous.
Yeah. Well, there's some of the sales I've got on at the minute. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. Very, very true.
Yeah.
Have you bought Batman Arkham Knight yet?
I almost did.
You almost did?
Yeah. But I looked at my shelf and saw, like, Doom, Ratchet and Clank because I haven't played. Yeah. And all these other games. I was like,
shit, I still got Ratchet and Clank to finish.
Yeah.
Doom, actually.
Yeah. And then my Skies came out, which one might play. And there's The Witness. Yeah, The Witness. Is that something I played?
Can I get a Witness?
Just put the
I haven't played The Witness. I've seen, I've played a little bit of it on SharePlay. My friend bought it.
Mm.
And we played a little bit on SharePlay. And it's very clever.
What I've seen, it looks very clever.
It's really cool. And it will consume your time. So.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I've given into peer pressure and I have downloaded No Man's Sky.
Nice.
I'm going to jump into it after this podcast.
Awesome.
With some ice on my neck.
Yeah.
Not the Jesus piece. Jesus peas.
Just Jesus peas. Yay.
Jesus peas.
You did it.
I did it.
But, I'm going to say something about the scar on my head, so never mind.
I think Jesus peas could be a weapon in our action comedy superhero game.
Sounds good to me. Just a bag of Jesus peas.
Yeah, just throwing peas at people. Frozen peas. That would hurt, though, if you threw frozen peas at people.
Yeah, it would actually, yeah. That would hurt. Like a beanbag gun. One of the beanbag guns.
Yeah. But yeah, we could do that, actually. That'd be good.
Yeah, okay.
Write that one down. We'll keep that one forever.
That'd be DLC. Bonus for all the DLC.
Yeah. Ben Hur.
Mm-hmm.
Not the 24-hour movie that's came out in ye olde times.
Ben Hur, the robot.
There's a brand new movie coming out of Ben Hur. It looks crap.
The first time I heard about it was watching SmackDown.
Oh yeah, the advertising on SmackDown.
Yeah,
I hate when they do that.
I know. It's
yeah.
What's this movie? It's nothing to do with wrestling, but it's a film.
Dolph Ziggler versus Dean Ambrose, sponsored by Ben Hur.
Yes, and Twix. Yummy Twix.
Oh, Twix.
Yeah.
Yeah, and KFC. You see these two muscly men rolling around in pants? You could be that, but you aren't because you eat too much KFC.
Exactly.
KFC. You're finger fat. Licking good.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's free. There's Ben Hur. Oh, I didn't even say it. There's like a tie-in game.
Yeah.
And it's on Xbox One, and it's free.
And it's garbage.
And it's supposed to be hot garbage. Yeah. Apparently, only touch it if you're achievement whoring.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, don't even go home. It's right on my list. Yeah,
gets the achievements, denies it forever.
Dude, I've got a bloody Avatar: The Last End.
Did you get that? You bought the Avatar game.
I rented it. Yeah.
Did you get the 1000G?
I did, surprisingly.
Yeah, it's not surprising. You got 1000G on loads of games.
I do,
but your gamer score is outrageous.
It is.
I'm on nearly 31,000 gamer score. You're like 180.
Yeah, 180. Just got over 180. Yeah, but I think. Inside got me over.
Yeah.
18, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, it's a lot.
You are hardcore.
I am.
Yeah.
No denying it, I am the best.
Yeah, that's fair. But there is somebody on my friends list who has more gamer score than you.
Yeah, me too. It sucks.
And I think went on his bio and it just said, fuck you, Finn.
Nice, cheers.
I think that's what it said.
Yeah.
I might have read it wrong, but I think that's what I might have said.
Nice. But I'm talking about people like over almost a million bloody games got at this point. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, they are enormous. Yeah. Can't fit out of the door and they have to be fed through a straw through the window.
Yeah, pretty much.
Because they don't leave their house.
Seems like it.
They're just like, the postman has to, like, literally push games through the window because...
Oh, what like, games?
Yeah. Like, eventually, it's going to be like the size of the room and he's going to have to buy digital.
Oh, dear.
It's like, you know, on that, I don't know if you've seen it, but there's like an episode of South Park.
Oh yeah, I've seen that.
Where they all get well fat by playing Warcraft.
Yeah, Warcraft.
That's what these people with like a million gamer score are like.
Yeah, pretty much. That's how
it's all over their face.
One day that'll be me.
Yeah. What's it's all over your face.
Yeah.
Massive. That Finn Balor t-shirt that you're wearing will be like a bra.
Yeah, pretty much. It all rips.
Just hello, I'm Finn Steele. We'll have to do the podcast over Skype.
Yeah, pretty much.
Because you just can't talk. Or you can't move.
Can't move.
Is that the noise that fat people make?
Yes, it is in my head.
In your head, that's what it is.
I'm fat.
Right. That's good.
I don't know. But yeah, that never happened.
You've got a little bit of news that I'm really excited to hear because it's a game that I'm absolutely stoked for.
I thought you would be.
Yeah, I've pre-ordered like every edition that you can pre-order.
You're joking, but I am legitimately super excited for this. Persona 5.
Who's joking?
Yeah. Persona 5 has a release date for Europe, finally. And it's going to release the same day as it is in America, shockingly.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Deep Silver, who's a new publisher. It's getting released February the 14th, Valentine's Day.
That'd be a nice present to yourself.
Absolutely, yes. In myself on my own.
Oh.
Alone in my house. it's coming with the standard edition, but it's also got the Take Your Heart premium edition for $79.99, which I pre-ordered. It comes with a soundtrack, selection of music from Persona 5.
Is this a Valentine's Day play on words?
Possibly. I think it's all about, like, hearts and stuff, the game.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. But comes with a soundtrack. It comes with a plush keychain, easy for me to say, of the cat character from the game called Morgana. Comes with a 64-page hardcover art book, which is awesome. It was awesome. Comes with a steelbook game case.
Jesus Christ, how much is this?
It's only $79.99.
Oh, is that all?
Yeah. Okay. But it's only like 20 quid more than what it normally costs.
That, to be fair, that's true.
And it also comes with like a school bag. It's like a, doesn't really look like a school bag.
Oh, you can
like
wear it to school.
Exactly, yeah, yay. Which is basically a big bag, which you can hold stuff in with the with the logo on the
game. It's like a man bag. I have a man bag for work.
Yeah, it's basically a man bag, yes.
Okay, but it has Persona 5.
Yeah, it's like the school emblem from the game on the bag in the corner.
Okay.
It's pretty nice. I'll probably use it because I'm a big nerd. It's also coming to PS3 for whatever reason. So if anyone out there still plays in PS3, you've got that to look forward to.
Right. Okay.
Yay. I appealed it. It's fine. Good.
That sounds good.
Very excited.
So I've just got some exclusive FIFA news.
All right. Okay. Can't wait.
The team that I support... See, I told you my voice is just on its ass.
Yeah.
The team that I support...
Okay.
Do you know who that is?
Manchester...
Mm-hmm. They are Manchester United are an official partner for the new FIFA game.
Sweet.
That's fucking awesome.
Is that it? Is that the news?
That is literally it. My friend just texted me.
Yay.
It's like United are our official FIFA partners.
Good for them. Good go David Rooney.
David Rooney.
Yeah, that's the one.
I'm pretty sure David Rooney's in the game.
Good to know.
Week 2 of the WWE 2K17 roster reveal.
Oh, sweet.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, I wish people had stopped texting me. I just keep getting drop downs on my phone.
Oh, dear.
All right, so the August 9th announcement in alphabetical order.
Okay.
Clear my throat.
I'm ready.
I ran out of coffee.
Oh, no, that's not good.
And I'm pretty certain that 35% of me is coffee.
that's not healthy.
I know.
How are you standing up?
Coffee, that's how.
I can't talk now. I've caught your disease.
It's not disease. The official term for it is probably a disease.
Yeah.
I don't even know what it is. I don't even know what I have.
It's a cold thingy, whatever it is.
Oh, cold thingy.
Could be.
Is that your Dr. Finn?
Yes. Doc Finn.
Doc Finn. That's pretty cool.
Thanks.
Okay.
I told him Doc Gallows.
Gullet Blob.
Yeah.
Alicia Fox.
Yay. Is she still in WWE?
Apparently so.
Yay.
Okay. Andre the Giant.
Okay.
He's still in WWE. He has a Battle Royal every year.
He does, yeah.
Baron Corbin.
Good.
Winner of said Battle Royal.
Yep.
Big E, surprising. Didn't think he'd be in it.
Shocking, yeah.
Yep. Billy Gunn.
Okay.
No longer works for the company, was fired for being juiced up.
Right, yes. Weird.
So that's a good one.
He's an arse man. Done.
Okay. Braun Strowman. He's not been any of the ones, has he?
No, it's first time. Wonder if he'll have his new haircut.
No.
No? Okay.
No, it won't. That's it a good just point, definitely won't.
Yeah, it's a new thing, isn't it?
It's too new.
It is. You're right.
British Bulldog.
Okay, cool.
Okay, look forward to never being him.
Yep.
Cesaro.
Cool.
Charlotte.
Good.
Daniel Bryan.
Good.
Edge.
Good. Superstar.
Jesus.
Easy.
Too ill.
Take it easy.
too much rated us. Superstar. Finn Balor.
Good.
Whose entrance they have released.
They have.
And they've released his champion entrance as the demon.
And, yes, it's the one with his chainsaw from Takeover Brooklyn, was it?
Takeover London?
London, that was it. Yeah.
Brooklyn. Yeah. It looks very cool.
It looks very cool, actually. Yeah, I liked it.
Far more promising than the Brock Lesnar entrance that they released last week.
Yeah, yeah.
Good crowd interaction.
Yep, the crowd does the arm thing. The ha ha.
Good impression.
Thank you.
Very solid.
Thank you.
I would say it's 8.5 out of 10.
Oh, great. Awesome.
Okay.
Move improvement, but...
Sorry?
Move improvement, but you'll get better.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, it looks very good. The animation was a bit more fluid than the Brock Lesnar one.
Yes, definitely, yeah.
The chainsaw noise is quite overpowering. It literally drowns the music out.
It does a bit, yeah.
But he doesn't do it for the whole entrance, so it's fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, it looks cool. Has your hype levels gone up based on that video?
A little bit, yeah. The fact that the animation is better and graphically looks a little bit better than last year. I am more excited than it was last week. Okay. So that's good.
Hideo Itami.
Good.
Jake the Snake Roberts.
Good.
Kalisto.
Fine.
Randy Orton.
Randy Orton.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Okay.
The Ultimate Fighter Sin Cara.
My favourite.
My favourite too. He's slowly becoming my new favourite. He's not even on TV at the minute.
Yeah,
well, he's on Slater, who's not even been drafted, is on TV more than the Ultimate Fighter.
He was on this week. He was on Raw.
Was he?
Yeah, he was Neville's tag team partner against the guys they wrestled.
To be honest, I didn't watch all of Raw because it was garbage, but we'll come back to that. The Rock.
Good.
Triple H. And Tyson Kidd.
Okay.
That concludes the August 9th announcements.
Cool.
Thoughts?
Yeah, pretty standard. Glad to see Charlotte in it, but of course she was obviously going to be in it. But, yeah, good.
Yeah, fine.
Fine. No big surprises?
No. In some other Billy Gunn, that's quite a surprise.
Well, yeah, that's quite a surprise for the wrong reasons, but yeah.
Okay. In some more WWE 2K17 news.
Okay.
Puff Daddy is curating the soundtrack.
Yay.
He's got a bit of everything in there, apparently.
Good.
I'm a music fan, and to be honest, the last couple of years of WWE games have had good soundtracks.
Yeah, they get old pretty quickly, though, I thought.
Well, we know the words to all of them. Like, we can just sit there singing the whole soundtrack, and in knowing the order that it comes in.
Yeah, pretty much.
But, yeah, they always have good soundtracks. 2K15 had a good soundtrack, including two songs by John Cena himself.
Right.
With Wiz Khalifa.
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's the thing.
Do you know who Wiz Khalifa is?
Is a rap man?
He's a rap man, yes.
Good.
I'm a rap man. This podcast is something else.
It is. It's the best. It's awesome. It's the best podcast in the lands.
Yes. All the lands. So yeah, how do you feel about Puff Daddy creating? I know he's one of your favourite rap men.
Oh yeah, I love all the rap men.
Yeah.
P Daddy.
Since
you can't think of any others. Snoop Diddly. M&Ms.
Yeah.
Specifically the peanut M&Ms, they're the best. lost it. It's done, podcast over. We've got a nerdy snort going on.
Okay.
Best podcast, 2017.
Oh,
16.
God.
16.
We're back.
I'll let this summon it out. Jesus Christ. What's the time? It's 33. Okay.
No, you've got to keep that in. It's amazing.
I'll keep most of it in.
Okay.
M&M's.
That's all we've got as far as gaming news goes this week, unless you've got anything else.
Oh, I've got one more, actually. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, really?
Last week, we did the Games of August, and I forgot one. It's Sonny's favourite game. Don't want to know about it. It's the best. It's Tatsune Miku Project Diva X.
Did you not say that one?
I think I mentioned it before we recorded, but...
I've pre-ordered the Super Mega Edition.
Yeah, you do, yeah.
You get a free umbrella.
You do, yeah. but no, it's actually a really good game.
We're still crying, to be honest. We're still literally wiping tears off our face from just a minute ago.
Man.
People are sitting at home listening to this again. That's not even funny.
Yeah.
What are they on about?
it's really not. but yeah, how do you make your body back? I like it.
Say that again.
It's a game.
No, no. You said the name of the game really fast.
Hatsune Miku Project Diva. Diva X. it's the third game to be released in this country. Fourth game, if you count the 3DS one. It's J-pop.
I'm glad you were air counting then, like everyone can see you doing it.
Yeah.
It's literally just me in this room with you.
But yeah, it's Frapper the Rapper, but with J-pop.
Oh wait, well that sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Now that you said that actually sounds amazing.
Yeah, exactly. It's definitely,
so it's a rhythm game.
Yeah, exactly.
With a story.
Yeah, like this newest one has a story apparently. The other ones didn't. We need to start on the list.
Which and what's this releasing on?
PS4 and Vita.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you getting it on PS4?
Yes.
Right, we're definitely going to do a video on it.
Okay, sure.
Because now you've said that it's like Parappa the Rapper, but with J-pop, that sounds incredible.
Yeah, it is. That's why, because when the first game came out, I was like, oh man, I'm going to love this game, aren't I? And then I played the demo and I was like, ah, yeah.
Wait, there's a demo as well?
I think there's a demo out, either coming out soon or coming out now. But for the first game, there's a demo came out.
On the Japanese, is it on the PS4?
I don't know if it's out on there yet. Be on there soon.
No, but the first one.
Oh, the first one. Depends on PS3.
Oh.
PS3 and Vita, I think.
Okay. Yeah. When the demo comes out, be sure to inform me because I want to see it.
Okay. I'm sure you'll love it. It's your favourite kind of game.
But I like rhythm games. I love Parappa the Rapper.
Yeah, I do. That's why I got into it, because I love rhythm games.
Right.
And I love anime and just J-pop and stuff, so why not?
I don't care about no anime. But like the rhythm game and the J-pop is crazy, man.
Yeah, like, J-pop's awesome.
It's just stupid.
Yeah.
So, This I've taken the piss out of you for these games, but now my interest is piqued.
Good.
Okay. I have a correction.
Okay. Can't wait.
it's not a big correction.
Okay.
Okay. It's last week we were talking about the sports games, and I mentioned Formula One.
Oh yeah.
Friend of the show Steve texted me and said, "I'm not nitpicking, but the Formula One season runs for about as long as the football season." I said it was like short.
Ah, right, okay.
So it's quite long. But it's not.
Right.
Okay.
Good to know. Thank you, everyone fans. Thank you, Steve.
Thank you. So, yeah. Right, let's talk wrestling.
Yes.
This has been a crazy podcast so far.
It has.
Wrestling. Wrestling. So, Conor McGregor is not a wrestler.
He's not.
Say that straight away. Okay. Mm-hmm. But he has a fight to promote, and he is apparently promoting it by having a dig at the WWE and WWE superstars.
Superstars, yes. Mm.
He says they're all, and I quote, fucking pussies.
Nice.
You're real nice.
Yeah, that's a bit.
And then he proceeded to sort of say fair play to Brock Lesnar for getting in there and fighting, but, quote, he's juiced up to the fucking eyeballs, end quote.
Nice. Well, I mean,
And then he sort of went on a tirade on Twitter and said, "No, I meant no disrespect to WWE fans, but I would beat the entire roster and kick their faces off or something like
that." Yeah, I think it was slap their heads off or something. Slap their faces off, something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
It's like, okay, great. What do you know?
And then but then of course then triggered off WWE guys responding to it and all this sort of stuff.
Like Sasha Banks saying, "Come at me, bro." That's cool.
And like Roman Reigns was saying, "You're about the size of my leg,"
yeah,
and all this sort of stuff. I hope Sin Cara hasn't caught wind of this.
Yeah,
just for Conor McGregor's sake.
Yeah, so Conor McGregor won't stand a chance against Ultimate Fighter.
Sin Cara is a war machine.
He is,
and I would love to see Sin Cara versus Conor McGregor. Because Sin Cara would kick Conor McGregor.
He would, I'd pay for that.
I'd pay for BT Sport just to stay up and watch Sin Cara versus Conor McGregor.
Yeah.
Make it happen, guys. Come on, Vince.
Yeah, come on, Vince. Book it.
Vince and Dana White. Come on, do this. Sin Cara versus Conor McGregor. Make it happen.
Yep. Have my money.
Sorry?
Have my money.
Yeah. Have all the money. So, yeah, I don't know why. I mean, this is clearly just fight promotion. There was point when I thought it might be a work.
Yeah.
It's not, apparently.
No. It's just an idiot being a troll, trying to get attention, like most trolls on the internet.
Yeah, he's attention seeking.
Yeah.
But apparently he's a WWE fan.
Yeah.
But let's be honest, Brock Lesnar would probably kick his fucking head in.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Brock Lesnar is massive. Conor McGregor is not massive.
He's a tiny man.
He's a tiny, tiny man.
He could whip me to pieces, so I'd be careful what to say. But
well, I don't think he's listening to this.
That's right, him. Or is he?
If he is, Finn has called you out.
What? Yeah, yeah. Come at me, bro.
It's Finn Steele versus Conor McGregor.
No odds barred.
No odds barred. But Sin Cara is in Finn's corner.
Yeah. It's a 2-on-1 alley match. Me and Sin Cara versus Conor McGregor.
Sin Cara does not need you.
He doesn't. I'll just be in the corner.
Finn Cara.
Finn Cara, yeah. So that's a tag team name.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
There you go. That could be in our wrestling game.
Yeah, yeah. Can't wait.
Yeah, good. Unfortunately, we have some unfortunate news to report.
Oh, yeah.
Shelton Benjamin was due to return to SmackDown very soon.
Mm-hmm.
And we're all very excited because he's awesome.
Yeah, he is. He's great.
Unfortunately, the return has been delayed.
Yeah.
Indefinitely. Because he has a very serious shoulder injury that he has to have surgically repaired.
Yes. Apparently it's similar to John Cena's injury, except more severe. I think Cena's got like a partial tear or something. And Shelton's like a full tear. It's like, yeah, not good.
No, that sucks.
Poor Shelton, he does.
We wish Shelton Benjamin a very speedy recovery.
Yep, yep.
And hopefully he will eventually return to WWE and be awesome.
I hope so.
Yes. In better news, Ryback and WWE have parted ways.
Hooray.
Hooray.
Finally.
Yeah, he announced it. He did a video while driving, so that's smart.
Yeah, I saw that. I was like, what? You can just wait until he stops driving. What are you doing?
Yeah, can't you just do it at home?
Yeah.
Like, instead of just doing it now while you're driving and being very, very dangerous.
Yeah. Idiot.
Yep. He's idiot now, man. He's now taking independent bookings as the big guy.
The big guy.
So I'm assuming WWE own Ryback.
Probably.
Definitely, I would say.
Yeah, yeah.
Not that anyone else. You know, he will probably return to WWE at some point down the line.
Yeah, probably.
But for now, we can enjoy it that he's not there.
Yeah.
He's launching some nutritious supplement food gym line or something.
Yeah. Now you too can look like Ryback.
Maybe you should go for it.
Yeah, maybe I should.
Finn back.
Yeah, Finn back. Why Finn?
Yeah.
But yeah, the best match of his career was the last match against Kalisto on the pre-show, of all things.
Yeah.
If he'd have done that, like, years ago, he'd probably still be there now. But yeah, at the stance, he was a bit rubbish. You ready, wasn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
From the off.
Injured lots of people and just, yeah. He's a bit pants.
Yeah. My voice is going, so okay. I'm going to let you run us through the Raw and SmackDown quick results and I will chip in.
Okay, thank you. Right, so.
What are you going to do? Are you going to run through the matches like we always do then fill the gaps?
Yeah, pretty much.
I've not seen all of Raw.
Okay.
So I'll just say yes and I'll do some filler.
Okay. So we started off with yet another Enzo and Cass segment. Being as funny and entertaining as they always are. They were interrupted by Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens, which made it match late that night. Obviously, Kevin Owens and Chris Jericho versus Enzo and Cass. Wait, was that late that night? I don't remember now. No, that's a SummerSlam match, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, it was Enzo Mori with Big Cass versus Chris Jericho with Kevin Owens. That was it.
Do we think that they just don't know what to do with these guys at the minute?
Pretty much. I think, yeah, Kevin Owens shouldn't be in a tag thing. He should be, like, on his main event on his own somewhere.
Mm.
But if there's anything else for him, I guess it's fine. I like Chris Jericho.
I think they're both quite funny together.
Yeah, yeah.
I think Enzo and Cass, excuse me, need to either win the tag team championships or split up. Simply because at the minute they're not doing anything of any worth.
It's gonna get old eventually. At the end of the day, it's the same old, you know, stuff every week. It's just still funny.
So no, we think that about New. We would have thought that about New Day, and it's been going for ages now.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't know. I think the tag team titles need to be in Big Cass and Enzo's future. Big Cass has got more of a future than Enzo, and I don't want Enzo to go down the forgotten route.
Yeah.
It certainly does. I mean, they've only just come to the main roster, and here we are plotting their demise. But
it's way too early, but yeah, we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
But ended up, Chris Jericho ended up winning that match via DQ. What even happened? Jesus Christ.
What do you want here? WWE.com?
This is WrestlingNewsWorld.com. Wrestling. Way too specific about everything. I don't know. Joker won. It was fine.
Okay. It was fine.
Yeah.
This is fine. I mean, this is it's building up a nice little feud leading into SummerSlam that will hopefully end at happen at SummerSlam and then end at SummerSlam.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm. So
after that, we had once again another squash match with Braun Strowman versus local jobber. You haven't named one here, which is a shame. Before the match, Braun did the same way. He asked him how he felt, and he was just silent and looked really nervous.
He got an entrance as well.
Yeah, he did. He got an entrance, but he looked very very nervous coming down to the ring.
I think he had BGM 3 off WWE 2K16.
Yeah, quite possibly. But yeah, he got torn to pieces by Braun Strowman, which is always fun to watch.
Yeah, sure.
Actually, we like Braun Strowman now.
Really?
Yeah.
Like 3 weeks and it's like changed your mind.
I know, yeah, but like it's just not just another added like white family member. He's just like his own guy.
Friend of the show Steve thinks he's going to be taken on by the Big Show eventually.
Ooh, that wouldn't be good.
We'll stick it in the predictions for friends of the show.
Yeah.
And guests.
But yeah, that would yeah, I don't want that.
Nobody does.
No.
Although he's lost a ton of weight. Have you seen the Big Show picture?
That's true, yeah. He has.
Yeah.
But after that, we had a backstage segment with my favourite person, Puff Diddley. Or Pete Daddy. Whatever his name is. Talking to Mick Foley and New Day. And yeah, that was the thing.
Baby!
Then we had a match with Titus O'Neil versus Darren Young again. Mm. It was an okay match. Darren Young ended up winning this one. Via cheeky roll-up. Grabbing the tights like Titus O'Neil did last week. It was fine.
And this match, this feud will come to an end on the pre-show at SummerSlam.
Yeah, pretty much.
That can't be on the main card. Saying that, is SummerSlam 4 hours again this year?
Because
they keep harping on about special start time, so...
Oh, yeah, it could be.
So it was four hours last year, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Too much. After that, we had a in-ring segment with Seth freaking Rollins.
Yeah.
Hyping up his match for SummerSlam with Finn Balor.
Yeah.
I mentioned how Finn Balor isn't his real name. Well, guess what? Seth Rollins isn't your real name. what's his name? Oh, I can't remember.
I can't remember either.
Something weird.
Something weird? Is that his name?
Yeah, that's a
weird name.
I went by Tyler Black in the Indies.
Yeah. That's I like that.
It. Yeah, I like it too.
But I like Seth Rollins too.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
I'll look up your name in a minute. Anyway, after that, we had an actual match. Sheamus versus Cesaro. It was actually a really good match, I thought.
Yeah, it was a good match, actually, yeah.
Yeah. Sheamus to put on a good match for once. Sorry, Sheamus. I do like Sheamus, actually. He's better than people give him credit for.
Yeah, Sheamus gets a hard time, but I think he is good. I think he's sort of in this period at the minute where they have no idea what to do with him at all.
It's good when he wrestles the right person, I think, like Cesaro.
Yeah. Like when he was in a feud with Daniel Bryan, they always had really good matches.
Hmm. I agree. Like his 3 second match at WrestleMania.
Yeah, it was one of his best performances.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then we had the Dudley Boys. Versus, they're still around apparently, versus Neville and Sin Cara, Ultimate Fighter.
The Ultimate Fighter, Sin Cara.
Yeah.
Hardest man on the roster.
Yeah. So Neville, they had that thing on like the pre-show where Dudley Boys confronted Neville. Said, oh, you've got to find a tag team partner and we're going to beat you because we're tough.
Right, okay, good.
And Sin Cara came out. He's got like a new attire. He's got an all black mask and all black like tights.
It's because Sin Cara's hard as fuck and doesn't care what anyone thinks.
Yeah, pretty much.
He just wears black.
Yeah. It looks alright, actually. I liked it.
Yeah, it's cool. It'll be out of date on WWE 2K17. It'll be, like, green or something.
Yeah.
We won't be able to edit it.
Yeah. Then when Sin Cara won, there was some dissension between the Dudleys. D-Von, and I think D-Von clotheslined Bubba during a match by accident. And, you know, after the match, Bubba was, like, staring at him, giving an evil glare.
Could we see the return of Reverend D-Von?
God, I hope not. That'd be terrible.
Testify,
oh my brother.
However, I would like to see the return of Bully Ray.
Yeah, give him a good singles run on WWE.
Yeah, that'd be fantastic.
That'd be good, yeah.
Because he's still really good. It's the D-Von that keeps making the mistakes.
Yeah, I don't have to say it, but yeah, it's kind of D-Von, isn't it? It's holding him back.
They're not even that old, you know.
No, how old?
Well, in their 40s. That's not that old, really, when you can consider like Ric Flair was wrestling way into his hundreds.
Yes, that's a good point, yeah. Oh, but then we had the Rusev and Lana marriage thing. not much of a new era. This is more like an old era thing, I thought. The old
this
wedding
is more
thing.
Like Macho Man and Queen Elizabeth, like SummerSlam 91.
Yeah, except it's overdone and boring.
It's crap. Like, no one cares for this shit on TV anymore.
Yeah, I agree. But
I like Rusev, and I think he's awesome. He's an awesome wrestler. Mm. Great that he's got the US title. This Lana stuff just really holds him back.
Yeah, pretty much.
Which is a shame, because Lana's great as well.
Yeah, she is.
She was a great heel character, yeah. Like when they first came in together. But like this marriage stuff isn't... I know they've got married in real life. Fine, tell the world, do whatever you like. Who cares? We don't want to see that crap on TV everywhere. It's like we don't want to see the Miz and Maurice kissing on TV everywhere.
Yeah, well, they do a lot better than Rusev and Lana, I think. At least because they're like... That's not their character. They're supposed to be like these cringeworthy, like, movie star kind of people.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. But, yeah, okay. Rusev interrupted. You pushed Rusev into Lana, and Lana got...
Rusev interrupted?
Roman Reigns interrupted. Rusev interrupted his own wedding. But Roman pushed Rusev into the cake.
Of course, a classic or Lana cake, into the cake spot.
Yeah, pushed Rusev into Lana, and Lana went into the cake. And just shouted a bunch. Right. So, yeah.
I am looking forward to that match, though, at SummerSlam.
Yeah. I don't think Rusev did an awful lot. Christ, did it again. I don't think Roman did an awful lot to earn the title match.
Rusev Reigns.
Yeah, Rusev Reigns. And they just kind of turn up and say, I'll fight you.
That is pretty much how it happened. Like, they had a stare down, and they did like a Superman punch.
Yeah.
And now this week he's not Lana into the cake.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Now he's ended the title shot.
That's how you get a US title match.
Yeah, it's push your opponent's wife into some cake.
Yeah.
Sorted.
There we go. So if someone wants an IC title match on SmackDown, yes. Just put some cake in Maurice's face.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. Title match is on.
Yeah, that's what Polly
Creed disrespect do. My wife or girlfriend by putting cake in their face.
Oh, dear. Right, yeah, we had an actual women's match. Hooray.
Hooray.
Sasha Banks versus Dana Brooke. With Charlotte.
Of course.
Yeah. It was okay. Dana's still very green, very new, as you said before. Just saying, I do think she's got a lot of potential. She just needs an extra while in NXT, I thought.
They just brought her up too quick. We've said this so many times. Wasn't there a stipulation to this? Like, she wanted... Oh, yeah. If Sasha was to win, it'd just be one-on-one. But if Dana... It was weird because the segment... Like, Sasha Banks went bursting in backstage and be like, I want them both two-on-one.
Yeah.
But then it was almost like, so Sasha wants this, but if she wins, she doesn't get it. And if she loses, she does get it.
Yeah.
It's like a weird, sort of not very well thought through bit of story that they've added in there.
Yeah. For no reason. Handicap match for no reason. Why? Why do you want? Why?
I want a handicap match. Well, you can have it, but only if you lose. What? Yeah. Okay. If I just lose then, I guess.
Stipulation was if Sasha wins, Dana is banned from ringside. But if she loses, then Dana will then it'll be a handicap match with Dana.
Despite Sasha Banks wanting a handicap match.
Yeah. But Sasha won, so there'll be no Dana at SummerSlam.
Right.
Hooray. Unless they pull another Ric Flair thing where she just comes down anyway.
Or like the club when they were banned from ringside and yeah. They just turned up anyway and ruined the match.
Yeah. Meh. After that, we had a tag team match. Kofi Kingston with Xavier Woods versus Luke Gallows with Karl Anderson.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't great, honestly. Not the best match, I thought. Very quick. Luke Gallows ended up winning. I think he's a white winner.
Yes.
There's no biggie because he got injured last week. Because he got
injured,
balls.
In quotes.
Got his balls squashed.
Yeah. Puff Daddy said nuts, didn't he? On. P-Daddy. We're going to call him P-Daddy now.
P-Diddly.
P-Daddy.
But yeah, they did a funny segment where, like with Gallows and Anderson, with their doctors and talking about biggie. Getting his nuts squashed.
Okay.
What do they call it? What the hell is it called? Ring postitis or something like that.
Ring postitis.
Yeah, something like that.
I like it.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that match at SummerSlam.
That'd be a good match, yeah. I'm looking forward to
that. Next week, we'll be doing our SummerSlam predictions, I guess, on the podcast.
Yeah, we will.
And then we'll do the prediction show on the Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to have to do two streams that weekend because NXT as well.
Yeah. Okay. Fine with me.
Busy stuff.
Busy.
Is NXT on the Friday night or the Saturday night?
I think Friday on the day. I could be wrong. I'll look it up later.
Okay. Finn's going to do a trailer for this one.
Oh, yeah, we'll do. Hopefully.
Okay. What do you mean? don't laugh like that.
So I'm just going through the results still.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that. Oof. Have you just forgotten how to read?
No, this website's a bit crap, really.
Right.
Okay, so the main event. It was Cesaro versus Rusev for the United States Championship. Cesaro came down and complained about not being utilized correctly, and how he won his match against Sheamus second week in a row. So yeah, it's good.
This
match,
was during the Daniel Bryan McFoley segment in the ring, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was it. They were doing the thing.
Raw was crap this week. This is why it was a bit crap. If we're sort of stumbling through Raw here, it's because it wasn't very good.
Yeah.
Like, I guess like a 2 out of 10 for me, Raw this week. It was so bad.
Yeah. But yeah, it was a good match with Rusev. Rusev ended up winning, obviously. Sheamus interrupted because it's Sheamus, it's a bad guy. And that's going to be a feud going forwards. Shrug.
Yeah, fine. So it looks like we're going to have Cesaro versus Sheamus at SummerSlam.
Yeah.
Fine, I guess. I mean, we've had it 2 weeks in a row on Raw. Do we really need to see it at SummerSlam? No, probably not. I bet we get it on Raw next week as well. Then it doesn't end, probably, and then they'll have like a no DQ match at SummerSlam or something.
Something like that, yeah. Same dumb.
Garbage. Finn Balor wasn't on Raw, was he?
Yeah, he wasn't, no. That was weird.
But they showed like a video package of Finn Balor going into to do this feud for SummerSlam?
Yeah, it's sort of like the demon thing and like where he got his name from and all that. Which is pretty cool. It's pretty cool little video, I thought.
Yeah. They'll both be on Raw next week.
Yeah. But it would have been, thought it would have been better to have him like have a match. He's only debuted, been there for like 2 weeks.
Yeah, and two matches on the first time he was on it.
Yeah, and most people there haven't seen it before because it's not a lot of people watch NXT.
It's weird pacing on Raw. Weird at the minute. I still think they're trying to figure it out.
Yeah, I think so.
Because obviously they used to have Dean Ambrose on there and all this other, you know, all the other guys. So I think they're still really trying to figure out how to fill that 3 hours properly.
Yeah.
They need to think hard and figure it out very quickly.
Yeah. But yeah, it can't be good every week. The first week was good. Second week was less good.
Why can't it be good every week?
I don't know. Raw, it's like 5 hours. They've got 5 hours to fill every week. And it's like,
yeah, but there's different guys now. So like, the roster's split.
Yeah, I guess.
So SmackDown can be good. Raw and SmackDown can both be good every week if they're done right.
Yeah, I agree.
Right.
Yeah, it'll take time, I think. I think so.
I don't know. I just want them to figure it out. Like, the first week was so good. It's hard to top that, but it doesn't mean you have to put a crap show on every week.
Yeah.
They're really hyping the Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton thing up on both Raw and SmackDown.
That's true, yeah.
Showing the RKO, showing the F5, and I don't expect to see Brock until SummerSlam. I don't know if he's booked for Raw next week or anything.
There might have been, actually. Yeah, I think I saw on Raw, they said Brock Lesnar is appearing next week.
Okay. Doing something. I want to talk about Brock Lesnar for a minute. Before we go on to SmackDown, I want to talk about Brock Lesnar. So, I know you haven't seen it, but Dean Ambrose was on the Stone Cold podcast this week.
Oh, yeah.
And it was a strange interview. I thought Dean is very sort of relaxed, and there was definitely certain things he didn't want to talk about that Stone Cold was really sort of pushing him to talk about.
Mm.
And I think it was pissing Stone Cold off, but whatever. Yeah. But there was a very interesting thing. Obviously, Dean Ambrose fought Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania this year.
Oh, yeah.
And Dean Ambrose said, like, on his way to the ring, he was pissed off.
Oh, okay.
And Austin was like, why were you pissed off? And he was like, I just felt like I was pulling teeth. Because I was like, saying, you know, he thought this match could be the craziest thing. Like, you know, one of the craziest matches of all time.
Mm-hmm.
And he was pitching these ideas, and they were just getting knocked back. Yeah. Like he said the words, like, and I think he just had to say it. Because Austin was really pushing him. He went, Brock didn't want to do anything artistically.
Ah, right.
Brock didn't want to know.
Yeah. He just wants to suplex people.
And he was like, I had all this sort of stuff in mind and I was just met with laziness.
Mm.
And that to me is why, and I thought that was going to be the case anyway with Brock.
Yeah.
Like, I get the feeling, and this is why I'm not that bothered about seeing Brock on TV anymore.
Yeah.
Brock Lesnar's not a professional wrestler. Brock Lesnar is a crossover combat athlete.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and Brock Lesnar's in it for himself. He's in it for the mega money that WWE pay him.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, all he's literally does 15, 20 suplexes in a match and just looks intimidating.
Yeah.
And then F5 and then wins.
Pretty much.
I won't be heartbroken when he's no longer a part of WWE anymore.
Yeah. I think it was cool like the first few times, but I think it's just the winner's course now, I think.
It's the same thing all the time.
Yeah, it's the same match every time, basically. Just different opponents.
Yeah. And it must be frustrating for guys like Dean Ambrose, who wanting to put a really great match on, just to be met with, oh yeah, well, just do a load of suplexes and you can hit me a bunch of times, but I'm, you know, eventually I'm going to win anyway, so why do it?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
And I expect much of the same from Randy Orton versus Brock Lesnar, and that's why I'm not overly excited by it. I think it's going to be fine. But I want Randy Orton to win.
Yeah, same here. He won't.
No, he won't. No. Oh, well.
Anyway.
Let's move on to SmackDown.
Okay.
And I thought SmackDown was a better show than Raw this week.
It was.
I like the pacing of SmackDown. I still think there's a couple of tweaks that they need to make. They still need to figure out its own identity and where all the divisions are headed.
Definitely.
And that was made apparent again this week by the tag team thing. Talk to me about SmackDown, Finn.
Right, so they started off with the Wyatts, all these Bray Wyatt and the other one. Not Luke Harper, the other one.
Eric Rowan.
That's the one, thank you. just saying how Bray should be in the main event. He's like, he's the god of SmackDown or whatever. He was saying, Dean Ambrose came down to interrupt. It looked like he was going to confront them both in the ring. And then Dolph Ziggler came down.
Just came steaming down to the ring.
Came steaming down, walked right past Ambrose, straight into the ring. Beaten up a bit. Ambrose came in to help, I guess, or at least fight, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, and they both got beaten up.
Yeah, they both got beaten up. Dolph Ziggler ended up super kicking Ambrose by mistake.
He looked good, though.
He looked good. Bray was going for Sister Abigail. He lifted him up and basically into Ziggler's foot and ate a super kick.
Yeah, I liked it because
It was all right.
It adds to the Ambrose and Dolph Ziggler feud.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, stokes that fire a bit. But, it, you know, it also sort of makes the Whites look awesome still at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good.
I don't know what's going to happen here with Bray.
Yeah, I'm not sure. He deserves to be in the main event picture, for sure. But I don't know. They might get added to SummerSlam, maybe, with Dolph and Ambrose.
I think it's too late now. There's only one episode of SmackDown left. And it's too late to do it.
Yeah, he probably won't.
But I'm quite excited to see Ambrose versus Ziggler now.
Yeah.
I wasn't, but I am now.
Yeah, that'd be a good match.
Yeah.
After that, we had American Alpha versus local competitors.
Yeah.
AKA Jobbers.
Local competitors. So, two guys, one fat, one thin.
Yeah.
And
we said this last week, that they should be going up against Jobbers instead of actual guys.
Yeah, because they went up against the Vaudevillains last week, didn't they?
Yeah, yeah.
Which was weird.
It was.
But that... It was weird again this match because obviously we knew American Alpha was going to win.
Yeah.
So it was just American Alpha in action. Okay. And then who came down first? The Ascension.
Oh yeah, that was it. So obviously Jason and Chad won. And the Ascension came down. I think it was after match, during the match, wasn't it?
Yeah, during. Yeah.
And
so did the Vaudevillains.
Yep, the Vaudevillains and the Hype Bros.
Oh yeah, the Hype Bros. But so obviously they're trying to build interest for a tag team division on SmackDown.
Mm.
Daniel Bryan obviously hinted last week on Talking Smack, is that what it's called?
I think so.
That they were going to, you know, eventually have tag team division, tag team championships and a women's championship also. I like the look of this tag division and I think there's potential there. I mean, about the Hype Bros.
Yeah, they've got five teams there.
Yeah, for now. I mean, there will be more. I mean, there'll be new people come in.
That's true.
So, but you know, there's enough to build feuds for a good few months going forward here because you only have to have one at a time.
That's true.
So, be cool to see the Ascension back in the picture.
Yep.
Be cool to see the Vaudevillains do well.
Yeah, yeah.
And the Hype Bros are the Hype Bros. That's fine.
They're also there.
Yeah. But, I mean, I'm excited for a potential tag team division here.
Yeah, me too.
There was a big brawl at the end. Everyone got involved. And American Alpha stood tall at the end.
Yep.
They are the big tag team on SmackDown at the minute. And I feel like they hold a lot of stock in them.
Definitely. I think they'll be the first tag team champions on SmackDown.
They've got the most
momentum behind them.
Yeah, and they're awesome as well.
Yeah, they're great.
Yeah. Do you think we're going to get blue championships?
Possibly.
Do you remember before when SmackDown and Raw had both separate titles?
Oh yeah.
They had the Raw ones had red stuff on them, like red worlds or whatever.
Oh yeah.
So I wonder if it'd be the same this time.
Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah. They like the colour schemes, don't
they? They do.
Or WWE.
The blue brand. They keep calling it the blue brand. So yeah. I'm the captain of the blue brand. Okay. That's fine.
After that, we had a match. Becky Lynch versus Eva Marie. Even when you came down to the ring, about to get ready to fight, and she had a wardrobe malfunction, quote unquote.
Yeah, yeah.
Her top kind of fell off, kind of. Just standing there holding her boobs.
Holding her titties.
Holding her boob titties. Titty boobs.
Titty boobs.
And obviously the ref got a towel and said, oh, the ref, the mask has been waved off because there's one wardrobe malfunction. And Becky Lynch was like, nah, screw that. I want to fight someone. Bring someone down. And Alexa Bliss came down.
Big fan of Alexa Bliss. And she's established herself straight away, I feel.
Mm.
I think she's... I think she looks the part.
Yep.
She talks well.
Yep.
And she wrestles well. And obviously, that's the most important thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So she has it all. So you can really see why she was called up to the main roster.
Yeah, yeah.
So early on in her career. She's a great heel as well.
Yeah,
really
a great
good.
Heel. She's got the evil scowl down to a T.
She has, yeah. But she's excellent. And I'm really happy to see her sort of doing well. And, I mean, it's interesting because obviously they are going to have a women's championship on SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
But you wouldn't look past Alexa Bliss to carry that division forward.
No. No, I'd be fine with that.
I mean, Becky's obviously, you know, she's a big player.
Yeah,
Natalia's there.
Yep.
Eva Marie is building up an interesting character, I feel, at the minute.
Yeah, I gotta love it, honestly.
I do quite love it as well.
Yeah.
I like that it's going to piss people off, and I think that's what she's there to do. We said that last week, didn't we? We were like, she's the heel, make her the heel.
Yeah.
Just let her be the heel. She doesn't need to be anything else, just let her be the heel.
Yeah.
So the women's division could be very strong. Carmella is fine. I think she's still developing, though.
Hmm.
Don't think the fans are buying into her talking, unfortunately.
Yeah.
They weren't in NXT.
Yeah, true. It's basically female Enzo, isn't he?
Yeah,
it's
but
not
she,
as good.
it doesn't resonate with the audience like Enzo does.
Yeah.
So they're building a quite an interesting women's division there, I think.
I think so. During the match, Eva Marie came back down, said, oh, I'm ready to fight now. I'll fix my top. I'll be all in order. that distracted Becky Lynch and Alexa Bliss. But I finish her off, which is the Twisted Bliss.
Yes.
It's a very awesome looking move.
Formerly the Sparkle Splash.
Yes, formerly the Sparkle Splash. And Alexa Bliss ended up winning. It was a great debut.
Yeah, really good. So I'm impressed. I'm intrigued to see where the women's division goes, you know, moving forward. Hopefully after SummerSlam we'll start seeing some championships, so they're fighting for stuff instead of sort of Becky becoming frustrated. I mean, the stories are fine. I mean, Becky's obviously going to fight Eva Marie at some point, maybe even at SummerSlam.
Yep.
Because there'll be another excuse next week.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And I think this is good. I mean, weird starts the women's division when they all came out on that first night, but now they're all sort of starting to float about, and I like that.
Yeah, I like it too.
Yeah, sure. Naomi's on SmackDown as well.
Yeah, she is.
So she could carry the division also. So
yeah, she's good.
There's some flag bearers there.
For sure, yeah, I agree. More so than the tag team division, slightly.
Yeah.
Because right now, tag team division is American Alpha and the rest.
Whereas
the women's division is...
You have to build these people up to make you care about them.
Yeah.
Like, I want to see the Ascension wrestling on SmackDown.
I do, actually, yeah.
And I want to see them destroy some jobbers like American Alpha did.
Yeah.
You know, and build them back up again, make people care about them. And then, you know, when they do have a tag team championship run, then it's fine and people are okay with it. But American Alpha will probably take the belts first.
Yeah, will do. Right, and after that, we had another match, Randy Orton versus Alberto Del Rio. It was a good match, I thought.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
Yeah, very good. Ended by a DQ when Alberto hit Randy with the chair.
I'm glad that Del Rio didn't go over clean here.
Yes.
Because that would have pissed me off. Because you hear a lot of stories about Del Rio at the minute and how he's not happy with his position in WWE.
Yeah.
But he likes working there because he likes the structure of WWE and he likes the security of it and blah, blah, blah. But Del Rio is underrated.
Oh, yeah. I agree.
And underutilized 100%.
Yeah. I 100% agree. I'm glad that he was kind of aiming for like Randy's arm with the chair, trying to injure it for his match with Brock.
Yeah.
I thought it was a cool angle.
Yeah, Del Rio's really good. I want to see him in the main event picture.
Mm.
I would like to see him be the next number one contender after Ziggler.
Yeah, sure.
Because I imagine Ziggler will lose at SummerSlam.
I would imagine so.
And then, you know, you could have Del Rio versus Dean Ambrose. That'd be great. I mean, I like Del Rio. I've got a lot of time for him. If he's going to stick around in the company, they need to push him.
Yeah.
Because he won't stand for that crap. He'll just go back to Lucha Underground and do whatever he does there.
Exactly, yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's cool. After that, we had Rhino versus Heath Slater. If Heath Slater wins, he gets a contract for SmackDown.
Yeah, interestingly, they mentioned Rhino's political exploits outside of WWE.
That was a bit weird. It's one of the characters doesn't seem like the kind of guy who would be into politics.
Run for a local office or whatever
it is. Yeah, a bit weird.
In Detroit. But I like Rhino. I enjoyed the backstage interaction with Rhino and Heath Slater. I thought it was quite funny.
Yeah,
and Heath was like, oh, I've got two kids. And then it all of a sudden went to four kids. And Rhino was like, well, wait, I thought you said you had two kids.
Yeah.
You know, whatever. I've got a pool and all this. That was quite cool. I thought that was quite funny.
But yeah, that's good. It wasn't an okay match. Rhino ended up winning with the gore. Which is very cool. I thought there was some sort of twist to that. Did Heath Slater get distracted by something?
I think he may have, but I can't remember.
Yeah.
Did he try and cheat and then got distracted by the ref?
Oh, that's it. Yeah, he tried to pin Rhino because he had his feet on the ropes.
Oh, he tried to put his feet on the ropes.
Yeah.
Yeah, he tried to put his feet on the ropes. And then ref caught him. It was quite funny because he went for the top rope.
Yeah.
Which was pretty cool. So, and then Rhino finished him off with the always impressive looking gore.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was cool.
Got a lot of time for Rhino.
Yeah, me too.
I like that he's still relevant today, like he was 10 years ago.
Yeah, it's cool. Good stuff. Also, after the match, we had the backstage segment, and we went to Daniel Bryan and Shane McMahon to complain. They were going to offer him a contract anyway, because they liked his attitude, but didn't get a chance to, because he was just complaining and shouting.
Yeah.
And stormed out of the building. He's like, yeah, well, no contract for you then.
I think he'll end up on SmackDown.
You think so?
What, you think he'll end up on Raw?
I don't know. Could be. I don't know. I'd be into SmackDown because that'd be a better place for him, I think. But
yeah.
Who knows? We'll see.
They showed, I don't know if we've missed this out or whether it's been already, but they showed, there's like a segment on that SmackDown live table thing.
Oh, yeah.
With Miz and Maurice. It was quite funny.
Oh, yeah. That thing.
Where it sort of cut back. Like, they showed a video package on Apollo Crews because he's the number one contender for the IC title. And it cut back to Miz and Maurice and they were both lying on the table.
Yeah.
And you can tell it was funny because the crowd laughed as well.
Yeah.
So you knew it was really funny. And then, like, Renee's in the middle. I thought that was quite cool.
Yeah, it's just like, oh, God, what's happening?
Yeah.
That's good.
Like, I don't want to see Miz and Maurice kissing on TV every week because it annoys me, but
yeah.
I guess that's the point.
Yeah, that's the point. But it's very funny.
Yes.
Then we had Carmella versus Natalya. Last week, Natalya attacked Carmella before her match. And this is the result of that. She tried to attack him again this week, but Carmella noticed her and turned around and punched her in the face.
Mm.
And it was a decent match, I thought.
It was good. Yeah, it was okay. I mean, it's nice to see women's division matches on SmackDown, especially as they've only got 2 hours to fill. So it's good that they've had two full women's matches on SmackDown.
Yes, it makes it up a lot of week when they didn't have any. So yeah, it was good. I thought the announcers didn't do the best job at selling Carmella's finisher. Just like when she locked it on, she just kind of sat there in silence. Said, oh, I think that's our finisher. Oh, and she won. He's like, oh, okay.
Yeah, which is a shame because Mauro Ranallo is usually very good at sort of making things sound important and making things sound big. But I don't know. Maybe they just weren't expecting it. I don't know. Maybe they weren't expecting it. Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? But it was a decent match.
It was fine.
Quite good.
Makes the division look good again. Makes everybody look like a competitor.
Yeah.
And I know I keep saying it, but I think after SummerSlam, we'll start to see the women's championship, come to the forefront and the tag team championships.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of tournaments.
Yeah.
So I think, that would be a really cool format for SmackDown.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, second round of the, you could have there's 8 women on SmackDown, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You could have, those matches building up and then you could have the finals at Backlash.
Yeah. That'd be
which
cool.
Will be after SummerSlam, a couple of weeks after.
Yeah.
Same for the tag team titles. I mean, it'd make me want to watch because I want to see, like, this Cruiserweight Classic.
Yeah.
I'm into it. Big time because of the tournament format.
Yeah.
I'm like, right, well, definitely. I want to see this person go through. And you see all these, you see the brackets, and you're like, well, that's going to be an awesome match. And we'll talk about the Cruiserweight Classic actually after this.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah.
Cool. After that, we had a quick backstage segment with Baron Corbin attacking Kalisto because they're still in the feud, apparently.
Yeah, sure.
It's fine. I know both these guys. Kalisto's not the best talker, as you found out during the draft.
Yeah.
But he's a good wrestler.
Lucha
things.
Things.
Woo, yeah. And Baron Corbin, I like.
Yeah, Baron Corbin's awesome.
It's a baby metal fan, like me. Yay.
He's what?
It's a fan of baby metal, the band.
Right, okay.
Which I'm also a fan of. And so it's Xavier Woods. So
right, okay.
I'll like him for that. main events after that. Yeah, Dean Ambrose and Dolph Ziggler versus Bray Wyatt and Eric Rowan.
This is a real Teddy Long main event.
It really is, yeah.
Yeah. But it's fine. You know, it was always going to happen after last week.
Yep.
When Bray attacked the two of them.
Mm-hmm.
It was fine. Bray looked strong at the minute. It was a fine match.
Yeah, it's okay. It wasn't, no, I don't know, it wasn't that well based, I thought. There's a couple of weird moments. Yeah, I don't know. It was okay.
Yeah, it was fine. Served a purpose.
It did. Ambrose and Ziggler ended up winning, because of course it did.
Yeah.
And Dean Ambrose gave Ziggler DDC after the match.
Yes.
Because
it's weird, because is Dean the heel? Or is Dolph the heel? Or is nobody a heel?
I think nobody's a heel. I think you're going for like a face versus face thing, which is fine. Every now and again. I don't know, just two good wrestlers wrestling, I guess.
Which is all it needs.
It's all it needs, yeah.
NXT has proven this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Time after time. That you don't need a heel and a face. You can just be two wrestlers that the crowd are behind.
Yep, yep.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
As long as there's a story there to be told. And I think there is with... I think that's why they've gone for Dean Ambrose versus Dolph Ziggler. I think it's like an experiment.
Yeah.
To see if they can get away with this on mainstream TV. Because obviously NXT is only on the WWE Network.
Yeah.
And I think they want to see if they can do it with these guys on the main roster on worldwide television.
Yeah. That's a good point, actually, yeah.
Can we have a face versus a face and just tell a wrestling story of one man wanted to go for the championship, one man wanted to defend his championship?
Yeah.
And I think it's proven successful so far.
I think so.
And I'm excited for these matches at SummerSlam.
Yeah, me too. It'll be a good match.
Yeah, sure. So I think, what do you think? I think SmackDown was better than Raw this week.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't think it's difficult because I think Raw was crap. But...
yeah, but, yeah, I definitely agree with you. The two Cesaro matches in Raw were cool. Other than that, I don't really remember an awful lot about it.
Mm.
Nothing major really happened.
Raw just needs to figure out what it's doing. It needs to figure out its pacing, and it needs to figure out sort of what everybody's doing. You've got a roster, you've got a set roster of guys there, and you've got a 3-hour show to fill every week. You don't need comedy segments with wedding cake.
No.
You don't need...
You need P-Daddy.
You don't need P-Daddy in there. You don't need any of that. People want to see wrestling and stories.
Yeah, pretty much.
They don't need nonsense.
Yeah. You don't need added filler garbage.
No, you don't. But once they figure out that format, because the titles need to mean something.
Mm.
So, yeah, I get that the club and the New Day are feuding for the championships. Fine.
That's
but
cool.
They need to make the titles feel important, and they need to base the stories around them.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. That's cool. So SmackDown was better than Raw this week.
Yep.
Next week, of course, is the final hype for going into SummerSlam next weekend. So that'll be interesting.
Yep.
We'll see the final confrontation between Seth and Finn before SummerSlam, and same on SmackDown with the other guys. Be nice to see. I mean, apart from Apollo Crews and Miz and Dean versus Dolph, is there any other SmackDown matches on SummerSlam at the minute?
We've
got Randy Orton and Brock, I guess, but
yeah.
That's one of each.
Yeah, that's a good question. I don't think so. They'll probably have a women's match on there.
Oh, I think we'll get Becky Lynch versus Eva Marie finally.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, that'll happen.
But
need a tag team match. American Alpha versus someone will happen, I'm sure.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe like a 4-man team, like American Alpha versus Zenshin versus Nightmares versus World Winners.
I think apart from Finn versus Seth, Dean versus Dolph, Brock versus Randy Orton, the build up for SummerSlam's been a little bit patchy.
Yeah, has a bit.
Has the Club versus New Day been officially announced for SummerSlam?
Oh,
you've got Cena versus AJ, of course.
Oh yeah, that's the thing.
Neither of them were on SmackDown,
yeah,
were they?
Yeah, neither. Weird. That's
very strange. So the build up to SummerSlam's been pretty weird so far, but I'm still looking forward to the show.
Yeah, me too.
But as always, I'm looking beyond it.
Yeah, I am. It's like what comes next?
Okay, so it's like this card's fine. But
yeah.
What's going to happen with the women division on SmackDown?
Yeah.
What's going to happen with the tag team division on SmackDown?
Yes, interesting.
Yeah. Let's talk about the Cruiserweight Classic before we go. Have you been watching it?
I have. Yes.
Let's just take a second to appreciate Tommaso Ciampa versus Johnny Gargano in last week's main event on the Cruiserweight Classic.
Yeah.
That was outstanding.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely a match of the year contender.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
They're two of my favourite guys anyway.
Yeah.
But they put on a hard-hitting, very... They told a fantastic story of two friends who just wanted to be the best and wanted to progress in this tournament and would do anything to do so.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the beauty of it, because you don't need nonsense to tell a great story.
Exactly, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. It's so many good moments in that. Like part where the jumper took down his knee pad, took a knee in the head and thought, no, can't do it. Put his knee up and then obviously Gargano countered it.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And the lovely moment at the end of the match when they were both sitting together in the ring. And it just told a great story without trying to.
Exactly, yeah. He's like, they didn't need to have that storytelling in the Cruiserweight Classic because there hadn't been any else. Like,
yeah, they were just drawn together. There was no build-up for this.
Yeah, exactly. And it was great. It was perfect.
Yeah.
That couldn't have been any better, that match, I think.
No, it couldn't have been.
Yeah.
But I think the tournament as a whole has been fantastic at the minute.
Oh, yeah.
We're going into round two starting tonight on WWE Network. It's just been great. I can't praise it enough.
Yeah.
How great was Rich Swann?
It was so good.
So good. That's standing 450.
Yeah, I was about to say, yeah. How did he do that?
He's just crazy. Such an athlete. I love the music. I love that the crowd are into his dancing. He's one of my favourites.
All night long.
Who do you want to win it?
I think after their performance last week, it's got to be Gargano, surely.
I would love to see Gargano win it.
Yeah.
There's a lot. I like Jack Gallagher. I thought he was awesome last week.
Yep.
And the crowd love him as well.
Yeah, he's
and
great.
I think he will... be one of the ones that maybe signs with WWE.
I'm sure they will, yeah.
As long as
they
don't put him with the vaudevillains and ruin him.
Oh, God, no. They'll be in the Cruiserweight division on Raw, I think.
Yeah. I like Ibushi.
Yep, he's great.
I don't know. I want Johnny Gargano to win it just because I'm a big Johnny wrestling fan. I think he's awesome, so I'm going with him.
Yeah. Yeah, same here.
But I like Rich Swann. I like Brian Kendrick.
Rich Swann's
great. It's just so hard to pick because that's why it's such an awesome tournament.
Yeah.
Because you like all the guys. You got Tajiri still in there.
Yeah, Tajiri's great. Oh, my goodness.
Guys, if you haven't checked out the Cruiserweight Classic yet, you really need to. It's different than what's going on the main roster. It's even different to what's going on NXT. It's a wrestling show.
Yeah.
And it showcases all sorts of different styles. Cruiserweight, mat-based submission wrestling, high-flying, strong style, all of that sort of stuff. It's really fantastic.
Yeah.
And before we go, how awesome is Bobby Roode's entrance music on NXT?
It's glorious.
It is glorious. Have you seen we've seen Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa doing the glorious bombs Bobby Roode?
So good.
It's so awesome.
Yeah.
But, you know, outside of the main roster, if you don't watch stuff outside of the main roster, there's still people that don't watch NXT, which is amazing to me.
Yeah, I know. You should.
You know, you really are missing out. Go watch the Cruiserweight Classic. Go watch NXT. Especially if you're getting fed up with the crap that's on the main roster at times.
Yeah, seriously.
There's so much good stuff out there waiting for you.
Yeah.
Really, really is. So that's pretty much it for this week.
Mm-hmm.
Next week, we'll be doing our SummerSlam predictions.
Yep.
And, we'll talk about NXT. We'll do our NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2 predictions as well next week.
Okay. Okay.
And... of course, next Sunday we'll be doing the streams.
Yep.
We'll be doing the SummerSlam stream on the Sunday. Mm-hmm. And we'll find out what day NXT is and we'll do that.
Yeah, that'll be helpful.
And I think it's either Friday or Saturday, isn't it?
August 20th, which is... yeah, Saturday.
Saturday?
Yes.
Okay, so NXT Brooklyn 2 stream on Saturday, SummerSlam stream Sunday.
Yes.
So lots of stuff coming next week, including a brand new podcast, of course.
Yep.
But for now, thank you very much for listening.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
And we'll speak to you next time. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you
very
much.
Bye.
Bye.